What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the YouTube channel. It's Rachel here with Maker's Gonna Learn, your ultimate die cutting community. If you do not know who we are or what we do, click the very first link in the description below to see how you can become a member today and gain access to not only thousands of cut files and hundreds of fonts, but we have amazing printable guides which allow you to master your machine. We have a great Facebook community that allows you guys to get crafty with over 10,000 amazing people, and we have amazing training for beginners to get to learn their machine. It's an amazing community, so go ahead and get your membership today. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the best printer you need for Cricut Print Then Cut. Here we have our Canon TS8320, and it was our winner from our printer comparison. If you are interested in learning about that video and all of the different printers we compared, I will click that link down below. We compared three different Canon Pixma printers from a price range of $40 all the way to $250. And this Canon came out on top for overall best quality. This little guy is $150 with ink refills around $25, which is really not that bad. As you can see, it printed really well. The lines are crisp and the color is sharp and clear. We really enjoyed this printer for all of our print and cut projects that we do. We really enjoy it. It works great with our Cricut, all the Cricuts. If you have a Cricut Explore Air, a Cricut Explore Air 2, or a Cricut Maker, as well as if you have a Silhouette Cameo or a Brother Scan and Cut, it would also work great for those options too. We really love this printer and everything it can do for you in your crafting journey. A few more things we love about this Canon printer is that it's really easy to connect to your device that you're using and also to Wi-Fi. If you are a Cricut beginner, that means you're also a Cricut Print Then Cut beginner. And we know how it feels to be a beginner. We don't want to overwhelm you. This is a very easy printer to work with. It is small in size and not very heavy, so it is good if you have a smaller craft space. And also, if you guys did not know, in Design Space, Cricut Print Then Cut will actually limit you to only being able to use a maximum size of 6.75 inches by 9.25 inches. Because of that, you don't need any kind of larger paper tray or larger printer that uses a bigger paper or anything like that, unless you print on your own time without Cricut Print Then Cut. It's an overall really, really good printer. We really like it. It's great, again, like we said, for beginners. And again, the print quality is really, really nice. It prints very sharp, very clear. The colors are really nice. We really can't say enough about this printer. Since this was the middle tier printer in our printer comparison, we did choose this one for the overall best printer for beginners with Print Then Cut. However, the print quality is a lot better than the most economical printer we did compare. And it is not a big jump from this printer to the big, more expensive printer we compared as well. So this is a really good middle ground for quality when you're looking for printers. The cheapest one, again, you can learn a ton more in the actual full comparison video that I will link for you down below, but the cheapest printer was $40. This guy being $150, we really notice a great jump with that. And again, if you do spend a little bit more on a printer, you will get that back, really. You do get what you pay for. This is a really good, sturdy printer. We have probably been using this printer, I would say, maybe 3 good years, and it's really not given us much trouble. We really love the top tray for Print Then Cut. If you didn't know, the top tray is really important for a lot of materials you will use with your Cricut, as other materials can curl and might be a weird, have a weird finish on them. If you're loading those in your bottom tray, they will have to go up and curve around your printer, and most of those materials will get jammed. So we really do like that this also has a rear tray. If you would like to purchase this printer, we will have a couple links down below for you guys to choose from. It's a great overall printer. We highly recommend it. However, if you are still on the fence or you would like more options, again, click that link and watch that comparison video. I give a lot of information on those great printers. I hope you guys enjoyed this simple video talking about the printer you need for Print Then Cut. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked this video, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Leave us a comment down below if you have any questions. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos just like this one. We release content for you guys every single week. It's amazing stuff if you want to learn how to use your machine. On that note too, guys, click the very first link in the description below to see how you can join in on our community and get endless education, motivation, and inspiration to use your die cutting machine. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. Bye.